Okay, here we are, about to enter turn 19. I think we're just going to try to finish it off now because I don't think there's a whole lot for the Reds to do other than take Poland, and we'll see if we actually can get that done in the one, two, three, four. Was it six turns left we have? So let's go ahead and roll for initiative. I don't think. I guess if the whites get it, the Poles would obviously go. Sort of my dice. Here they are. Nope, because as usual, the Reds have rolled a tie and they get plus one anyway, so they retain the initiative and go there. Pretty easy, actually. I think we're just going to have to really think about how we want to keep assaulting here. But first thing we're going to do is roll random events and do strategic movement because I have some armies I want to move down into this front specifically. So let's go ahead and roll the white event. Oh, they get seven. Is that typhus? No, it's an armored train. And I can actually put it with a Polish unit. So that's actually pretty interesting. Feel like they had an armor train and those go away forever. Oh, they did. I already removed it. Okay, so armor train comes in. And I think we'll give it to. An army's pretty beat up. So is this one. And there's a lot more forces coming here. So I think we'll do that. Go ahead. Although. They are at maximum stacking, so actually I can't use this because I don't have anywhere to put it without it violating stacking rules. So technically that event does not occur. That's too bad. The Poles really could have used that. Reds are going to get a leader, which we don't really want. So let's really hope we don't. So this is actually where it starts getting bad, start getting leaders because we already have the kind of leaders we want. I believe there's only one leader left to put out there. It is Vatsatsis. Let's go ahead and see where Vatsatsis is going to go. Oh, he's in the main south front. Okay, well, that's interesting. That's good. Okay, good. Hopefully, we don't. Now we can't have any more leaders be assigned. Actually, that's pretty good. So I'll take that. Okay, so let's do strategic movement. Can't really get the red train anywhere close to Poland. Because of the rules. And I think what we're going to do is we're going to move this Latvian Rifles unit. It's hanging down in Samara. It's going to come down here. I think it's going to go to Minsk. Yeah, it's going to hang out just outside of Minsk. It's going to go there. Is there anybody else I want to move? Yeah, I'm going to move this army here in Izvestk. And also, I think that's the only one I can move. Yeah. Let's go ahead and move this guy, and he also will come down to Minsk. Just so I can get more armies down there. Just trying to really put more pressure on this front. So now, as you can see, I should probably show you where I put those guys. So that it makes a little more sense. Brought them both here into Minsk, 12th Army, Latvian Rifles. So that's a nice potent force coming down here. We need some more. Those armies are kind of hurting. And I'd like to keep pushing on the Poles if I can. They do get this special event called the Miracle of the Vistula. Which is something they can go back, they basically get really good benefits one time. Let's go ahead and look at that up. Once per game, when Poland is at war and there are supplied red units within 3 hexes of Warsaw, the white player may declare the Miracle of the Vistula during any logistics segment. All Polish units in or adjacent to a Polish-controlled Warsaw may automatically rally. In addition, the white player may immediately replace one eliminated Polish army if available. At full strength and within stacking limits. And he may add one white tank and armor train unit each to any normal eligible hexes in Poland. So, I mean, you get a tank and an airplane, it's pretty good. Pretty good. So that's the one like special event they can do. Okay, so Soviets are going first. And we still have the airplane. Don't forget, we still got the airplane. That's actually gonna be very helpful. Let's pull out just a little. Okay, so what would be the best front, I think, to assault on? I could basically take this stack out down here because it's getting trapped, and I could put a guy here and make it take an extra loss, although it could just go here, I guess. And, because I guess I could go here and then have another unit go there, right? I think I could do that. It's so funny that I've been playing this game so much, I'm still questioning really simple rules, which should probably tell you that I'm either not very good at remembering rules, Or there's just wonky kind of rule movements here, which I don't think is really the truth. Or movement rules, I should say, not rule movements. So yeah, we can keep moving. I don't know what I'm thinking. I'm kind of thinking I've got weird movement restrictions, and I don't think I do at all. Yeah, it's just got to say with stacking, and you can't, a zone of control to make you stop. And you can't leave out of supply. So could I do that? If I went here with this army, could I have like another army go here, here, it'd still be in supply, and then come here? Two, three, so it would have to be that. Okay. Or I could just go one, two, three, but then see that guy cuts off supply. So what you gotta do is you gotta go bring that guy there. Okay, I guess I should say I'm gonna activate this front then. Let's go ahead and activate the south front. Oh, it'd be kind of smart to get an attack on this guy before he just kind of rampages on that army. No, let's go ahead and see if we can cut him off. Let's go ahead and attack here and see if we can get this done. So we'll go ahead and attack here. We'll do the southwest front as our first chit. Go ahead and show that so we have it all official. Southwest. Most of the chits that won't do anything will also go into the cup. Okay, southwest. So let's go ahead and do this. Fifteenth Army will go there. Seventh will come here because they can actually reach due to supply now being preserved here. One, two. Actually, he ignored zones of control, doesn't he? Wow, one, two, three, four. We'll go ahead and put him there. One, two, three. That's our two stack. So we can only do two of those. And then I think, oh yeah, these guys are. Oh, there's a nice full strength army. Nice. So what we'll do is we will take this Cone Armia, we'll go here. And then we'll go ahead and just take this army and come here. And then honestly, these guys will just go here. And yeah, we'll put them there. That way we can just start getting more and more red forces over here and just choking Poland out. It's kind of the goal to do that. So just restrict the, deliberately restrict where they can go. Okay, so I think we've got a really good thing here. They're going to have to basically. Actually, they'll just be eliminated if I can do this properly. Because if they get a retreat, they have to go two hexes, and if they end up in a zone of control, they're done. Although, yeah, that guy makes a zone of control happen. Okay, so let's attack. We got 4, 8, and these are 8, so it's 8, 16, 24. Oh, the stacking bonuses just get so crazy. So we got 24 to 6. That's a 4-to-1 shift. It becomes 3-to-1 because he's in a city, so we're gonna roll 3-to-1 and rolling die. And I won't use the airplane here, although I probably should. I won't because we've got such good odds. All right, good. A 6 and a 5. So the Polish units got three guys in there, and that's 15 off the bat, 16 with that bonus. But then they also suffer, I think, -4. So it comes in at 12. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's 36 plus a bunch, so yeah, I'm gonna get maximum modifiers, not 3-to-1. And that is a DR, and that means they are all dead. They will all go away. Because the reason is they're gonna take a step loss, these other two guys will die because they were already reduced. And that garrison goes away too. And then because he has to do this, he dies as well because he has to go through zone of control and ends up in one, which is where he gets eliminated. That's what I was getting wrong. If you end up in a zone of control, you're eliminated. If you pass through one, I should have only had units take one more disordered loss result. That was my bad. Okay, and we'll move the Cone Armia up. Sweet. So this is looking better and better. Getting rid of those armies pretty much means I think we're going to win wholeheartedly as the red player. We'll see. We still got to get a couple things. I think we pretty much got something back. The West will do nothing. Oh, technically, those guys are in the West, aren't they? These guys in Minsk. Interesting. So I can't attack with them this turn, can I? So that means I should probably go after the Baltics here. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. So they're going to go 1, 2, 3. They'll attack there so we can get this over with. So we have what? That is a 5-1. That's a 4-1, even with the shift. So it still stays 4-1. All right, we'll roll that one. This should be a pretty ridiculously easy combat. Yeah, 3-2. So it gets a defensive value of 2. We get 6. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, so that's a plus 9 differential on a 4. That's a DR, yeah, it's done. And we'll advance, so yeah, we take that. There we go. And that was the West activation. All we gotta do is get Baku, take the Polish out, and we have this game won. All right, Central Asia, nothing's gonna happen in Central Asia. Southern Front, we'll just move on Baku. Make sure this camera fall. I've already had it fall once before. You didn't see it because I had deleted that video. Magic of editing. Okay. So yeah, they're just going to go after Baku here pretty easily. 1, 2, he doesn't even show. Actually, technically, I can stack in the south now, so yeah, I think I'll just do that because it can't do anything. So there. 8-1 becomes still 4-1 with all of the shifts and whatnot, and this is pretty much fait accompli. All right, 6 and a 5. That means we have 12 plus 6 is 18. He has 4, so we have a plus 14 on 4-1 DR. And he can't. Yeah, he dies. He just dies. So yeah, we take Baku. So that was pretty easy to do as well. AFSR has nothing to do. North and Islamic have nothing to do. The East, I guess it can go take out this Siberian partisan, maybe. Oh, I can't really do that, but it can make life more difficult for it. So, like, what we'll do is we'll just go 1, 2, 3. Yeah, because it always has access to the rail, so we'll just do that. And then, I guess, technically, I could get it. So, yeah, I guess I could have gone there and we'll attack. Just make this a whole... make it dead. Alright, it actually rolls a 6, but that becomes a 3. We roll a 5, that becomes an 8. So that's a, what is that, plus 5 differential on a 4-1. That's a DR, almost an ADR, but not quite enough, so it dies. Yeah. Alright, the Polish units get their activation. I think what they're going to do is just beat. Hasty retreat. Unfortunately, they're just surrounded, and they need to get back to Warsaw, and they can activate the miracle of the Vistula. But technically, they won't be able to get the effects of it unless they leave. So they'll just go 1, 2. Oh god. 1, 2. Yeah, we'll see if we can keep them off the river so we get at least some defensive shift bonuses there. Okay. I think we'll go ahead and declare our miracle. I think we're going to have to. Logistics, so we will declare the miracle of the Vistula. It means I get one full strength army, comes back there, everybody gets healed. And I, I can't get my tank and airplane. Because tanks actually take a spot, don't they? Oh, I get a tank and airplane anywhere I want, so I guess we'll give the tank to the Polish unit here. This will probably just die soon, but then that's just the way it goes, I guess. And then I get an airplane. We did not get one for the old, for the Allies, for the Whites, but now they do have one. Okay, so let's do logistics now. Everybody's in supply. I guess we'll just roll to see if any of these people heal, because the Polish guys did. So we'll do this one. Eighth Army gets the red die. Nothing. They're not hurt. We'll do this one. The third gets the red die. Nope. I'll do the Konarmia. It does heal, so yeah, that's not good for That's it. I think they got pretty much full strength everything else. So yeah. And that's it. That's it. It's pretty easy logistics. Not going to care about garrisons. The field staff chit we don't need to use because we've activated all of our fronts. I guess I could have moved that one army. The Siberians don't have anybody to activate, and that just leaves the Northwest, which honestly is not going to do anything either. So now we just move to strategic turn G. We don't have any armies to bring back pretty much everything we need. The Polish get to bring... I don't think they get any units to bring back. I don't believe the whites get a unit back. Do they? At least the Polish whites, maybe they do. Yep. Dun dun dun, peace with Poland. Yes, it doesn't say anything about them getting their units back, so I think that only applies to whites. AFSR and Siberians can do that, so yeah, they're not going to get a unit back. Okay, so yeah, we're just going to roll. So I guess that was it. There's nothing else really to do on that, because we don't have... Just to be double sure, I'm pretty sure this is the end of the game here. Victory check, allied withdrawal, reinforcements, we don't have any... Double check that they don't get that. I just said that, and I was like, they don't get any, but... Let's just be sure. During, yeah, I don't get any reinforcements. They came in at one time, I guess. Oh, I do get one Polish unit. So I do get to bring one Polish unit back at any place I like. So it's going to go to Krakow, because it's the only place I can get a unit in. Polish unit in. So yeah, he's gonna go there. Okay, so now we're gonna move to turn 20. It is September. We're gonna roll our two die to see for initiative. Reds once again have just steamrolled initiative rolls, so they're doing really good. All right, white random events. They get a 4, a pretty low one. I don't know if that's gonna be good for them. Tanks, so we don't get that because the allies have left. Reds get Semenov Cossack raid, that doesn't even matter. So yeah, okay. Reds get to choose the first activation, and I definitely think we're gonna do the Southwest Front because we have the most units there. So we're gonna take the Southwest Front out and say, yeah. And all these other chits go back in that are pretty much worthless. Let me stay out, Polish Army. All right. Okay. So here come the Southwest units, and I don't think this will be difficult. I think we're just gonna basically womp them. So does the Con Armia, do they need supply? Because they have that Z bar, they have a Z special marker, right? And so that means they get to ignore zone of control, but I don't think that if, I think they still need supply. Guess I should be looking at the zone of control rules because it doesn't have a special... This is why I really wish I had an index here. It just would be so much nicer if there was actually an index. Yeah, they just ignore enemy Zox. That's all they do. Okay, so yeah, we'll just keep him there. We'll go ahead and bring the other Con Army up. We'll do that. And... This one will go here. We'll go there. And then, let's put that guy there, and let's just go ahead and bring this guy over here. Yeah, we'll just do that. Not too worried about this. Okay, we'll make an attack here. We have 8, 16, 20 to 3, so we get the maximum attack. We are actually on the river, so he doesn't even get a bonus, so... Yeah, I think that's pretty much it for him. That's 3, so he gets 6, 7, because he gets a bonus there. But we bring 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We bring 20, so it's automatically a plus 14. So on a 1,000,000-to-1 attack, 4-to-1, he gets a DR result. So he has to go one. He's going to go back up here, two. Tanks are gone. And we'll go ahead and bring that Gon army up. Okay, so that was that move. And now we'll see who's next. South. The south is actually just done. I didn't even do a strategic move, honestly, because it just wasn't going to be worth it. I guess I could have. It's just going to bring a guy from Baku to Minsk. Yeah, that's what we'll do. Anyways, yeah, the west, south's got nothing to do. Northwest has nothing to do. A field staff chit, so I'll go ahead and just activate. Let's go ahead and activate the western front. And we'll bring this guy and go one, two, and then he gets a done marker because he's actually in that front now. All right. Central Asia has nothing to do. Logistics has come up. So everybody's in supply. Polish units actually rally on a roll of 1 to 3. So we'll go ahead and do that. And they both rally. And I'll go ahead and check these two guys. They don't rally. Check these two. This guy rallies. All right, that's it. All right. The east is not going to do anything. North and Islamic, it's not going to do anything. AFSR is not going to do anything. Siberian, not going to do anything. Oh, I guess that is all one front. What was I thinking? That is the west front. I guess all those guys could have come in and done something, right? I guess they could have come in and attacked. And I said he did that, so that's how we're going to do it. My bad. Polish get to act, and then it's the west. They already moved, technically. So yeah, the Poles get to act. I don't know if they're going to do anything other than... Yeah, they're going to have to do something, though. So they're going to go 1, 2, 2. And what do we have? 2, 4, 6, 8. Oh, is it even worth doing, like, a 1-to-1 attack on those guys? Yeah, it is actually worth doing a 1-to-1 attack. We'll go ahead and do that, and we'll bring in our sweet airplane. I think they'll bring in their sweet airplane, because we can do that anytime. So let's roll die. Got a 1-to-1 attack going on here. Ooh, this could be interesting, a 6-3 result. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so that's 36. And we get 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, so yeah, that's what, 51. And that's 6, 7, 8, yeah, so we got the most. And it's a DR. Okay, so they're there. So that means I got to retreat 2 hexes. That did hurt the Konar Mia. That is like a really good... thing to do, but that's really just buying them a little bit of time. And we'll go ahead and advance these guys up. Oh, yeah, and they got a DR, which means they lost their plane, too. So, ooh. Ooh, boy. Oh, wait, I didn't think about that. Oh, yeah, it doesn't even matter, because they rolled so poorly. Boo, that's not so good for them. Okay, so that was that attack, and we're done. So that's the end of that turn. Moving to turn 21, rolling for initiative. Reds win again. They get a 3-3, so they win again. And I think this time, yeah, we'll definitely take the southwest chit again. And what we will do is just the same thing we've always been doing. Go here, thanks. That's my dog. He just came here to make lots of fun noises. And we'll do that. And then we'll also... I can't do anything else, can I? Because I kind of want to bring these guys down. But here's what we'll do. Oh, he doesn't get to move because he's in the front. So yeah, this is all we're going to be able to muster here. That's actually plenty. Oh, wait. I have so many stacked units, don't I? I can't do that, so I'll have to just do that. So we have 8, 16, 20 versus what, 4? And they will bring in the plane. It says 20 versus 4, so that's, yeah, 5. Let's see what we got here. Ooh, another not great result. A 6, 2. So that gives them 12. They have 13, 14, 15. I have 5. That's 10. So I have 3, 6, 9, 11. So I have 21. What do you have? Oh, man, 21. So 6, 12, 18 plus 3. So that's 21. Did I miscount that? I think I did. Because he actually gets 3 units there. So that's 6, 12, 18 plus 3 is 21. They have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that's 10. 3, 6, 9, 10, 11. Yeah, so it's, wow, so 0 differential. On a 4 to 1 attack, that is a DR, little d retreat. It's just enough to push these guys back. And what they will do is they'll have to go here. All right, and this thing lives, surprisingly, because it didn't get a capital D result. And they retreated, so this army will indeed come up here. Go there. Okay, next, Chit. Oh, so many just worth. This is kind of where the game kind of bogs down, because you just have so many dumb chits that you don't really need to use. But you can't just, like, take out the ones that are necessary, right? Because you got to have those odds in there. West's going to do nothing. East is going to do nothing. Oh, wait, the West could do something, right? I guess West is going to do something, and the East will do nothing. Oops. Getting all advanced here. Yeah, we're going to have to start thinking about bringing armies over here. Poland may be a tough nut to crack, but I don't know about that. Actually, we may be able to cut it all. So yeah, what we'll do is we'll just say 1, 2. Yeah, we'll just completely bring the surround pain on these guys. And actually, I could probably try to go at these guys because it's 2 to 1. He's gonna get his damn plane. Oh, but it'd be nice to get rid of some of these guys, honestly. To go here. It would just become 1 to 1, though. And he gets not great advantages. 1 to 1 combat. I basically will take a loss unless I can get the highest one, and I don't really want to do that. Although he's just gonna get a combined attack on one of my guys, but I think it's just gonna be the way it is. All right, the East is going to do nothing, yeah. Okay, logistics. Unfortunately, we're just not able to get rid of these. I guess that's why I should have attacked that guy, because he's going to be able to rally now. And he does. All right, so let's see if our guys can rally. He is in supply, so we will see if he can rally. He does not. The 2 Konarmias, the top one does. That's good news. And those 2 guys. Oh, this guy did it. So that's not bad. We'll take everybody we can get at full strength. All right. Central Asia, no. Essentially, the only ones I need to do is the... Oh, I didn't even pick a chit to go first, did I? Oh, I did. Oh, the Southwest went, so yeah, this is basically going to be now. Oh, Poland hasn't gone, so that's one thing we're waiting for. AFSR, no. Northwest, no. Field staff, no. South, no. Polish, finally. And that makes the other 2 chits just worthless. Okay. So that's the last one. So the Polish units are actually going to attack too, because they've got to keep attacking. And what we'll do is we'll attack this, this stack here.
I should actually probably attack that stack, but I can't get the numbers on it, so yeah. And I don't want to get cut off here, so that's what we're going to do. We're going to focus on these guys. It's 2-4, 2-4-6, so that's, what is that, 10. Ooh, that's just still a 1-1, but we have lots of nice attacks, and we still have an airplane, so we're going to bring that in, and we're going to go. And we're still getting the rolls. All right, we're getting a 4-2 here, so we had 1, 2, 3, 4 by 6. 6 times 4 is 20. And they also get 3, 6, 9, 12, 15 attack. So they have 35. They rolled 2 times 2 is 4, 5, 6, 5. So yeah, they suffer the most horrendous results. A 1-1, they have a positive. It's a capital DR. So this guy dies. And this guy retreats. And they could move, but they won't. Alright, so the other two chits don't matter. Oh, I don't know if I'm going to be able to do this as the reds. Okay, rolling initiative. Nope. White's almost had it. Do not get it. So rolling for white events. They roll a 9. River flotilla. It is winter though, so they don't get that. Okay. Reds roll an 8. It's a red terror marker. I don't even care about red terrors right now, so I'm not going to worry about that. Strategic movement. Guess I'm going to take the army out of Baku and go send it over to Minsk. Yeah, I think I'm going to have to do that. And I'll take, actually I can go to Brest-Litovsk. Because I have that own, I don't have a marker there, but I do own it. And I'll see the Latvian rifles out of Riga, and they will also come to Brest-Litovsk, because I need to get more units there. This is where it gets hard, because this front's sort of divided into two. But because I can go first, I will take the Southwest chit, and we will see if we can do this. So, well, that's my dog whining. So what I need to do is just come down here and seize this for supply. So he's going to go 1, 2, 3. There we go, that gives me a supply. Hey, be quiet, guys. Come on, chill out. Every time I'm trying to do something, they're always like, "Brr, we're gonna make noise." Oh yeah, it's gonna be tough, isn't it? So we're gonna bring that guy there. Cause I can't get these guys to attack unless. It's like the most you can ever get is like 2, unless I can somehow bring guys up here. 3, and that's probably what we'll end up doing is coming that way. Tough. We'll bring this guy here. That guy there, this guy will go 1, 2, 3, he'll go there, this guy will go 1, 2, 3, actually I'll just stack with that, I can't double stack because I have 2 stacks already, so we'll do that. Probably should have like not left the Cone Armia just like totally exposed, but, and this is where my airplane would have been really handy. So it goes. Okay, so we're going to attack. We got 8, 16. He has 2, 4, 6. So that's 3-1. Just enough for 3-1. He is in a city, so that becomes 2-1, and he gets his airplane. So here we go. Let's hope for some nice rolls here. Oh, man, the red's just getting creamed on rolls. So that's 4. That's 12 for them off the bat, plus 1, 2, 3, 4. So that's 16 off the bat. We get 1, 2, 3, 4, and then we get, what is this? Do we get a full strength guy here? I think we do, right? That's 7, 10, 13. So I have, 17. He has what? What did I say that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 16. So I have a plus 1 differential on a, 2-1. That is an ADR result though. That is good enough for that. So, ADR. Make sure they don't retreat. So we'll take both our losses. I will take a loss here. He takes a loss there. And make sure Poland doesn't have some sort of weird rule about not retreating. Yeah, it doesn't say anything that they have to stay there. Let me double check with airplanes. I want to make sure they just don't die if you get like a D result or something weird. Oh, one combat per turn. Oops. Probably should not have been using him for multiple combats. Oops, I should have been putting the turn record track. Oh, that's what I should do. Aircraft units are eliminated by disorder result, but ignore retreats. Oh. So yeah, he actually is gone. That actually makes that airplane go away. So I goofed on that. I did, because I didn't use them that often, but airplanes, you use them once, then they go on the turn track. That's what I should have been doing. It's pretty easy to note that stuff. And if you get a retreat, they go away. So yeah, that's a big loss for them. And yep, so they're going to go one, two, and then the 3 and 4th army will come in there and hold it. So now if we get the logistics chit, then we win. We'll basically win. Yeah, because they'll surrender right away, all their chits go away, and then we have to keep 4 manpower points there, and then that's pretty much the end of the game. The West will actually probably do something since we have guys here. Yeah, that's what we'll do. This guy will go 1, 2. This guy will go 1, 2, 3. This guy will go here, and then we'll take these guys. Because they actually can't stack. And go 2, just so we can have full, complete destruction of their units, and they don't have any chance of doing that. So yeah, this has all become academic now. 8, 16, 21, 2, 4. So we got maximum mods. Yeah, we got him here, because he only gets 6, 7, 8, and I already have 1, 2, 3. If you've watched my videos before, normally I hit the fat button with my finger, or my fat finger hits the button, and I normally turn the camera off. This time I just ran out of memory on my phone, because I literally recorded like a 6 gig file or something, I don't know. Anyway, I just got to this, I looked it over, and I think we just left over one combat, which is when I just noticed it actually had finished. So let's go ahead and figure out this combat real quick. I think, I mean, this is all pretty much over, right? So this is 8, 16, 21, to what? So yeah, so we have all the maximum mods. So he gets, what is that? 4, 5, 6. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 18 plus a million. So yeah, we're going to get the maximum differential. He will suffer a DR result. And that will just kill him, everybody here, because he can't go anywhere else. That's a capital DR result. And I can advance if I want to, and I think I will, just because that's for fun, and that totally eliminates the ability. So now what we do is we literally are just going to draw chits until we get the Polish, or if we get logistics. No, North and Islamic. I mean, it's pretty much over, it's the Polish. Yeah, logistics, so Poland could not have ever actually retaken Warsaw. Oh, wait. These guys can't go... do that attack. Oops, that was... why did I think they could attack there? That was silly. So actually that battle probably may not have gone down the way I thought it did. Hold on. Oh, here they are. Yeah, there was those two guys, right? So it was actually just 4, 8, 12, 13 to 4. So that's actually just 3-1 odds with the mat. And so if it's actually just 1, 2, 3, 4, that would be 12 plus 3, 6, 9, 10, 11, so that'd be, what, a 23, and he would still have 6, 7, 8, so I'd still have plus 15, and that still is a DR result. So anyway, forgot. I should have marked him with a done. Did not think about that. And so here comes logistics. I am in possession of Warsaw. That means all these dudes surrender immediately. The Polish shit is removed, and we have to keep at least 4 manpower points in Poland, or else we lose the game or something, right? But, in effect, we've just won the game, because we don't really have anything else to do. We just took Poland, we own every resource city, so really what we would do is just, technically, you would crank out turns until you got to the end here, right? So we had 2 more turns to go. And, yeah, so there, that's Reds. That was Reds. I guess technically the Whites could get a partisan result and take some beer, so just for shits and giggles, we will see if they get that random event. Nope. And if they had 1 more turn... no. They would have gotten the AIF offensive twice. That's so funny. Anyway, okay, so there we go. Reds effectively win the game on November-December 1920. On turn 22, close. Polish is, they're difficult to take out. And you need almost every single one of your units over there to actually make it happen. And if I probably had been not screwing up some of the white losses, it's very conceivable that the Reds would not have won this game at all. Or at least with the, I try to go for the alternate history version here, right? If you take Poland, this is considered alt history winning. The actual other way you can win is to just hold every city inside of Russia outside of these two places. And I probably could have easily done that too. It would have involved coming to Central Asia though, and having to do some fighting. Not crazy resistance there. So that's probably, that's about it. So yeah, that's Reds. I think what I'm going to do is I'll show you the board, and then I'm going to stop, and then I'm going to come back and do just a little reflection and give my thoughts on it and talk about this as game as a whole. Just so we can see, I didn't really have to go everywhere. There are no resource cities up there, but I did have everything, and I was able to pretty much push everybody out. So historical arrogance in my game, the Reds traded taking Poland and spreading the revolution west for having more Central Asian descent. So, you know, I think that's a trade-off they could handle. Anyway, all right, so that's Reds. And when I come back, we'll do a little review video.